All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are just one show away from Rite of Spring. Now, as some of you know, we have 5 matches already confirmed. So, we have Los Macizos versus Sinful Youth, Mick Adams versus Pete Dunne, M Shadows versus Matt Tremont, Aaron Chaos versus Deonna Purrazzo and Vanessa Craven in a 2-on-1 handicap match, and we will have MJF teaming with Cool to take on Abyss and Kevin Nash. Winner between Abyss and MJF in that tag team match will decide the stipulation if MJF successfully defends his championship tonight. So, let's go for it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's run down the card of Rite of Spring. Because this one's going to be intense. Emma McGann is back in action after taking a little time away to get ready for her move. She'll be taking on Alley Catch, who you will be seeing at the GCW Collective this week. Then we have Matt Cardona taking on Mick Adams for the SIW Excalibur Championship. Matt Cardona, who will not be featured, apparently, at the GCW Collective this year. Then we have the debut of Peyton Sawyer as she takes on Anna Valentine. Then we have the East-West Express taking on Sinful Youth. The Madhouse Marauder, Mark Doring, and No Chill Scotty Rivers. The boys are back in town. Then we will be having M Shadows returning to action to take on Hoodfoot for the SIW Hardcore Championship. That is going to be absolutely exciting. M Shadows has just released some new music with Avenged Sevenfold with their new single, Nobody. Then, in our co-main event, it's Battle of the Beasts, the Monster versus the Samoan Bulldozer. We got Abyss versus Umaga. Then in our main event, as per request, MJF has to defend his championship against Austin Theory as per request of the Monster Abyss. Should MJF lose, it will be the Monster Abyss versus Austin Theory at Survival Fest next month. So let's quote my boy Larry Legend and say, I don't want to wait any longer. And let's start the show. Once again, here is your card. 3 title matches tonight. And now, Patreon.com, Big O Live, Kumu, and Reggins Brand Entertainment brings to you, in association with Fight TV, Fight Plus, and GCWmerch.com, the go-home show of S.I.W. CXW Agony. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I totally forgot to change the arena. So, we are still emanating from New Jersey. We are back at the H2O Wrestling Center in Township, New Jersey. Well, I'm getting word the reason why we're still here is because the fact of the matter is the Opera House in Toronto, Ontario, where we were supposed to be, was double booked and they had to bump us. So, before we even had a chance to pack our shit and leave, we got told we have to do it here. Tremont heard it and he said, well, more action for us. Let's go. So we ran down the card. It's going down. Emma McGann versus Allie Catch to kick things off. Let's not waste any more time in this event. Tonight's show is brought to you in part by Patreon.com, GCWmerch.com, Fight TV, Fight Plus, IWTV, and Pro Virtual Wrestling. Also, tonight's show is brought to you in part by the Drama Queens Podcast. Listen to behind-the-scenes scoop as Bethany Joy Lenz, Hillary Burton, and Sophia Bush break down episode for episode and answer your questions about One Tree Hill. You can find that available on all podcast platforms. Our opening contest is scheduled for one fall. Making our way to the ring first, she is from Coventry, England. This is Emma McGann. Emma McGann is making her way to the ring. Emma McGann looks ready, poised, and focused. Has been doing some amazing things in her life as of late. And it's amazing to see Emma in such capacity when we can. And this is her H2O Wrestling Center debut. We would like to thank Matt Tremont and H2O Wrestling for allowing us to have this on such short notice. And her opponent, Allie Catch. There she is. She's as dangerous as she is desirable. It's Allie Catch. Allie Catch will be in action for the GCW Collective. So you do not want to miss that. March 30th to April 2nd. Including Effie's Big Gay Brunch, The World on Lucha, Emo Fight, the Independent Wrestling Hall of Fame, and much, much more. The GCW Collective will be absolutely amazing. It also includes For the Culture and Josh Barnett's Bloodsport. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, the GCW Collective is going to be hot. WrestleMania is going to be hot. Pro Wrestling is going to be hot. So you do not want to miss out on what we are going to be watching. You get a chance to see me call the action on Big O Live for all these events, or as many as I can go for. But I won't be alone, let's just say that. But here we go, Emma McGann versus Allie Catch. here at the H2O Wrestling Center. The bell sounds, and Emma's going to start things off with some series of strikes and kicks and serious shots into the corner. Nice attack there. Emma coming in with a drop kick. Already kicking things off quickly here against the veteran Allie Catch. Catch is very well diverse in professional wrestling and is known to be quite the striker and have quite the amount of strength. Will her strength be enough to put Emma McGann away as we go back and forth? Emma with a, misses the clothesline to the outside. Emma's like clearly having some problems here getting control of Allie Catch, but Allie's now taking advantage of that misstep. A little bit of ring rust on Emma McGann right here. Nice power slam. McGann down. Cover. One. No. Emma McGann now getting up. Kip up. Catch now. Irish whip to the outside of the ring here. We are ringside now at the H2O Wrestling Center. Emma kips up once more. Is taking it. Oh. Misses the strike and is taken down at the seams here by Allie Catch, who is in firm control. Discus shot to the face. Catch now playing to the crowd. Miss Allison Catch, she is very intense. Don't let the good looks fool you. She is dangerous, as is every woman here in SIW. Emma now trying to mount a quick comeback here. The striking, the combinations. Oh, sling blade by Emma. What's this? Drop kick combination. Gonna go for a cover here. One, no, not even close to anything here at the H2O Wrestling Center. McGann goes in for another attack into the corner. Another drop kick. Catch is in trouble. McGann now going up. What's she going for here? Oh, beautiful moonsault cover. One, two, no, not enough. Not enough to put her down. Catch now being brought up to her feet, but is fighting back with all she has. Catch now bringing Emma into the corner. What's she thinking here? Another shot. Oh, what's this? Scoop and a slam. Catch gonna try and go for a cover here. McGann is feeling the effects. Cover, one count only. And the pace has slowed down. Wait, what's this? Emma's gonna try and steal it because, oh, round and round she goes. Loop-de-loop. One, no. Tries to steal the pin from Allie Catch. We got ourselves right back and forth here. Catch now trying to toss McGann to the outside. Got a series of great reversals here. These women are putting it all out on the line. Emma with a nice kick. Trying to really play into it. Drives her down on her head. Emma's going for a signature set of maneuvers here. She says she's not done. She hits that running shooting star press. And what is she thinking here? Going for a scoop slam. Going up top. Emma's going up top. What is she thinking? Big splash to Allie Catch. One, two, three. Beautiful match. Your winner of the match, Emma McGann. is victorious here, and Alley Catch does not look pleased. Well, we got another match coming your way. And this is going to be absolutely crazy to see. It's going to be Matt Cardona challenging for the X-Cal Championship. So let's not waste any time. Mick Adams, this is defense number 9, I believe. If he retains, he's got one more defense before things can be activated and he can cash in wherever he pleases. So that's going to be an absolute barn burner of affairs. Tonight's show also is brought to you in part by the Murder in America podcast and Paranormal Files YouTube channel. Go check both out for all things spooky and true crime. The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the SIW Excalibur Championship. Introducing first, your challenger, Matt Cardona. Cardona, who is got nothing planned for the collective, so it's great to see that he is here in SIW, ready to take on the world. So we will see what happens when hell opens up. And his opponent, he is your reigning and defending SIW X-Cal champion, Mick Adams. Adams, who was successful last show here at the H2O Wrestling Center. In his defense, could he keep that streak going? We've seen him and Cardona face off too many times. We've seen them, what they can do to each other. Well, now we're about to see what happens when there's gold on the line in an entire new environment. Cardona, Adam, X-Cal title, here we go. And Adam's going to start things off quick. He does not want to waste time. Firing on all cylinders right out of the gate. Trying to make a statement against an old rival. Series of chops, and look at this. Go, quick suplex here, cover. No, not enough. He's really trying to get inside the head of Matt Cardona and get him to expel all that energy. Cardona now. Oh, Spanish fly from Mick Adams. Adams now going up top. We are going for a nice splash here onto Cardona. Cover. One, two. No, that would have been quick and easy. Much like a Matt Cardona match should be. But we're not going to go there, ladies and gentlemen, as Mick Adams is in firm control, trying to secure number 9 so he can move on and get that activation of the cash in. You gotta have 10 successful wins with the X-Cal Championship to unlock that ability. And you get to cash in for either a number 30 spot at Calamity Clash next year, or a world title match at any time. As Cardona's going for, oh, 450 splash. Cardona really pulling something out of his pocket here. Adams is not moving. Cardona is just being all nonchalant, not realizing what is at stake here. Oh, and a Rough Rider. The Rough Rider. The Rough Rider. The Rough Rider and Adams. Adams is down. One, two. Oh, just like that, ladies and gentlemen. Mick Adams survives at the skin of his teeth. And that looks like it just angered him as he goes in for a nice DDT to Cardona. Now he's going to return the favor. One. No. Has that been a smokescreen for what's about to happen next? Oh, he misses that kick. Nice block here. Cardona now with a boot to the face. Instant kip up by Adams. Adams now. Oh, look at this. Reversal City. Cardona now looking like the fool. As Adams goes in for another nice little kick. Oh, he's tuning up. He's warming up. He calls this the Wakanda Clutch. It's down. One, two, no. Cardona kicks out of the Wakanda Clutch. You gotta be serious. You gotta be kidding me here. Well, it looks like we are getting set up. Walker's Edge coming in. Walker's Edge, that spear. And he's gonna go for another Wakanda Clutch, Wakanda Strike. Adams lays him out. Cover. Cardona in trouble. One, two, three. Mick Adams retains. Your winner of the match and still SIW Excalibur champion, Mick Adams. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Defense number 9 is successful. Defense number 10 will be at Rite of Spring. Who will face Mick Adams? Ladies and gentlemen, this is absolutely insane. Well, we have a very exciting debut that I don't think you want to miss. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Peyton Sawyer versus Anna Valentine. This is going to be absolutely exciting. Peyton makes her long-awaited debut, which was literally a shock to us here in SIW, even though we knew that Sawyer Scott, her daughter, has been quite the fan favorite here. So we could be seeing a Tree Hill resurgence happening. You never know. Peyton Sawyer has never been in an SIW or CXW ring, but her husband Lucas has. So you gotta wonder, has Lucas been teaching her things behind the scenes? Has Lucas been incorporating what he learned in his early time in CXW to help mold Peyton Sawyer? We'll have to find out. Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest features the ladies of SIW Wrestling. On her way to the ring first, being accompanied to the ring by Sawyer Scott. Making her official SIW debut. This is Peyton Sawyer. Peyton Sawyer is here in SIW, and boy, does she look ready. Boy, does Peyton Sawyer is here. Cheerleader, artist, wife, mother, friend, an all-around ass kicker. Peyton Sawyer makes her debut. And her opponent, this is Anna Valentine. The sinister sex bot herself, Anna Valentine, makes her return to SIW, as well as her official hardcore hustle organization, H2O Wrestling Center debut. We haven't seen much of Anna because she's been doing a lot of other things in the process. So let's see what happens here. Peyton Sawyer making her official debut against Anna Valentine. The bell sounds. Peyton takes a strike. Oh, a little swing and a miss there by Valentine. Now Peyton coming in with the strike. Dragon screw there by Valentine. Valentine, oh, misses the standing shooting star press as Sawyer Scott, Peyton's daughter, looks on at the intensity that her mother is bringing to SIW. Peyton now in control early on, and both women going for something but missing as Peyton drops her down with a beautiful drop kick. I can't speak English. Sawyer with a nice leg drop from the top rope. She is showing tremendous in-ring prowess. All the reversals coming in. Oh, reversal here. Look at this. Roll up. We got our first roll up into a bridge cover. One, two. Oh, that was quick. Peyton now coming in, clotheslines. Oh, what a comeback. Peyton Sawyer, what's this? Oh! That was nasty, I don't know what she calls that. Mixtape, what's this? Oh! Oh! Oh my god! One, two, no! That DDT did nothing! Peyton takes her down with a stiff clothesline. Valentine is still capable of getting things done here. No relation to SIW superstar Whitney Valentine, who we haven't seen in quite some time, but that leg drop might be the end of everything. Referee in position, cover. One, two, three. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner of the match, Peyton Sawyer. Wow, What a debut. Peyton's daughter looking on in awe and in aspiration as her mom has a successful SIW debut. Well, from women's competition, we're back in the men's division. Sinful Youth versus the East-West Express. No Chill Scotty Rivers teams up with his friend and longtime partner, the Madhouse Marauder, Mark Doering, as they take on the future of professional wrestling, Nick Wayne and Jordan Oliver, the East-West Express. This is going to be an absolute war. I cannot wait to see what happens when these two teams tangle up. This is going to be absolutely intense. Let's send it to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team match is set for one fall. Introducing first, the Madhouse Marauder, Mark Doering, No Chill Scotty Rivers. Together they are Sinful Youth. These two have exploded since coming to SIW and making a scene. These two have really taken the tag team division by storm. But their test tonight is a team of youthful energy, high octane, and extreme resiliency. Let's get this match underway. And their opponents, the team of Jordan Oliver and Nick Wayne, they are the East-West Express. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, two of the best in the independent circuit today. Jordan Oliver, who is the currently reigning Jersey Championship Wrestling World Champion, and Nick Wayne, who is a 17-year-old prodigy, second-generation superstar, signed with All Elite Wrestling. Nick Wayne's gonna start things off against the big man here, Mark Doering. Doering's a big, big, strong guy. We're about to see exactly how strong he can be. The strength of this man is just unparalleled. And as you see with those gorilla presses, holy crap. Doring's got some serious striking, but Nick Wayne is coming back. Trying to bring it to the man. Oh, missing the clout cutter. Trying to go for a clout cutter early on. Reverse sent to the outside. Oh, look at that. Sacrificing himself. But did that pay off? Did the distraction pay off from Scotty Rivers? That's why they call him No Chill, because he don't care. He'll put himself in harm's way just to get the job done. As Mark Doering is completely... Oh, he punched him right there and he turned him inside out. Missing that clothesline again. And Daring's back up. And back out he goes. I guess, no, he'll put himself in harm's way again. As we got a quick hot tag coming in. Oh! Going right for Big Breakfast. But Nick Wayne is in the way of everything. And Jordan Oliver now at the brunt of the attack. The strength of Mark Doering is absolutely terrifying as they are just pillaging and bludgeoning Jordan Oliver and Nick Wayne. Nick Wayne gets thrown down. Now here comes Scotty Rivers, who's a very intense individual. Fast, strong, agile, and absolutely unforgiving. The way Jordan Oliver's getting up. Oh. Will that be enough as he gets tossed to the outside? What's this? Rivers going up top. Oh, dropping the elbow to the outside. Jordan Oliver. Big Breakfast, the East Coast Ace, thrown into the ring post. Head first, no chill. It looks like Rivers is going back up. What's he thinking? Oh, double axe handle. Both men now. This is just craziness. Wait, Rivers. Oh! Reversal by Oliver. But wait, Rivers. Oh. Oliver now fighting back. Oh. Oh, drops him right on his head right then, right there. Oliver in trouble. What's this? Oh, he's got him in the Cobra Cut. Oh, he reached the ropes. He reached the ropes. And now a riot has broken out as Scotty Rivers. Oh, wait, Jordan Oliver. Oh, sweeps the leg. Misses that strike and a clothesline gets dodged. Sweeping the leg again does Jordan Oliver. Neck breaker. Dropping the elbow. Time to tag in the big man. And look at this. Oliver does not know what's going to hit him. He calls this the Marauder Driver. One, two, three, no! Jordan Oliver kicks out of the Marauder Driver. Oh, Oliver with a reversal. Sweeping the leg on Mark Doering. Picking him up, what's this? Oh! Oh no, he's gonna try and go for that Tiger Driver. Oh my God! He just laid him down. One. No. Striking him down. Wait. Oliver. Oh, wait. What's this? Oh! Driving the foot into the head of Mark Doering. Doering's up. And Nick Wayne's back in. And Nick Wayne is just taking it. Oh. Look at all the strikes this guy is doing. Cloud cutter and he misses. He misses the clout cutter. Eat the feet. Cover. One. Oh, broken up. Now Jordan Oliver going right for Mark, for Scotty Rivers and Mark Doering. Doering's in trouble. Nick Wayne's going up top. What's he thinking? Oh no, Nick, what are you doing? What are you thinking? Oh wait, what's this? Oh, jackknife powerbomb. We got a cover. One, two, no. Nick Wayne is still somehow, some way breathing. Oh. Wait, what's this? Doering. Jackknife. Another jackknife by Doering. Cover. One, two, no. Wow. Nick Wayne is still keeping his team alive. Oh, a super kick. Doering's in trouble. Doering's in trouble. One, two, three, no. Mark Doering kicks out. Tremendous reversal. Oh, what's this? What do we got over here? Oh! Doering gonna call for another Marauder Driver. Marauder Driver incoming. Down goes Nick Wayne. One, two, three. What a tag team match that was. Ladies and gentlemen, your winners of the match. No Chill Scotty Rivers. The Madhouse Marauder, Mark Doering. Sinful Youth. Sinful Youth proving why they are the true future of the tag team division here in SIW. Wow. That was insane. That was a great tag team match, ladies and gentlemen. Scotty Rivers, Mark Doering, proving why they are the top of the top in the tag team division. But ladies and gentlemen, our triple main event, the Hardcore Championships, kicks it off. M Shadows returns to SIW to put his title on the line against a legend in deathmatch wrestling today. Hoodfoot is no stranger to the Hardcore Hustle organization's H2O Wrestling Center. This match is brought to you in part by GCWmerch.com. And by Avenged Sevenfold's new single, Nobody, available now on all streaming platforms. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is for the SIW Hardcore Championship, and it's going to be contested under underground rules. Introducing first your challenger. This is Hoodfoot. Hoodfoot looking ready. Hoodfoot is looking focused. This man is a monster. This man is an assassin. This man is a killer. When that bell rings, he shows no remorse and no mercy. The cool thing about Hoodfoot is he does it with a look on his face that shows that he enjoys inflicting hell on his opponents. And his opponent, he is your SIW Hardcore Champion, representing Avenged Sevenfold. This is M. Shadows. M. Shadows making his H2O Wrestling Center debut. He's been in the studio trying to record some new music. His new single, Nobody, with his band, Avenged Sevenfold, is available now. And he said he will come out and show out to show that he still can hang with the most hardcore individuals. Hardcore Championship is on the line. Hoodfoot takes on M. Shadows. Underground rules. Shadows is already going to kick him. He's almost daring him to strike. M. Shadows took the championship off of Bray Wyatt and has held it ever since. But he has never faced somebody as menacing and as powerful as Hoodfoot. He gets sent down, crashing to the mat with that suplex cover. One count only. Shadows now. Oh, look at this. Telling Hoodfoot to snap out of it. But we are getting some strong back and forth. Shadows into the corner. Rams face first into the... Oh, that just angered him. The lead singer of Avenged Sevenfold is known for being brash and known for being tough. And we're taking it to the outside. Oh, that senton. As we are about to see what we can find under the ring. Ooh, Shadows has a kendo stick and he misses. Hoodfoot. Oh, the head of M. Shadows bounces off of the ring post here at the H2O Wrestling Center. What is Hoodfoot doing? Oh, he's daring. He is daring Shadow. Oh, luring the Hardcore Champion. There's that backbreaker. Stretching him out on the knee. It is underground rules. And Shadows is trying to fire back. Shadows now with a kendo stick. No! Oh. Oh, Hoodfoot just broke the kendo stick off of the back of M. Shadows. What's this? Shadows in trouble. Oh, getting slammed down hard. Cover. One. Just a simple one count. And Mo Atlas taking his time to taunt. What's this? Slam face first into the turnbuckles. Now lifted back up. Dropped on his face. Ooh. That Dominator. Shadow's now trying to find his way back into this match. Uh-oh. What is Shadows thinking? What is M Shadow? Oh! Oh no! Oh no, no, no. Shadows. Oh, get speared! Get speared for his troubles! One, two, for no! Oh my god. M Shadows. What's this? Trying to drop him face first. Hoodfoot knows exactly what Shadows was trying to do. Shadows trying to show that grit. And he throws him. Oh, no, 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 no. Shadows, what are you thinking? Oh, the senton through the ladder. Oh, my God. He just killed himself. Table now being brought into the fold. Shadow's going to try and set this table up. Oh. What's this? Oh, he just set that table up on fire. M Shadows. Oh my god. What are we about to see here? Up. No, Hoodfoot. Hoodfoot now trying to... Oh no. Whoa, 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 whoa. What's this? Oh. Flaming tables are very unpredictable, and the people using these weapons are very unpredictable here. As we got some back and forth slugfest action between M Shadows and Hoodfoot. Shadows now gonna try and play these games. Oh, Hoodfoot knows exactly what he's trying to do. He throws Shadows to the apron. Oh, it's hard to see with all that fire. The spine of Shadows hits the apron. Wait, Shadows is back up. What does this mean? What does this mean? Oh, both men. Well, Shadows. Shadows. Front suplex. Oh, he's really trying to toy with him here. Uh-oh. Shadows slams him through the table. Scoop slam through the flaming table. Hoodfoot. One, two, three. Wow. Your winner of the match, and still SIW Hardcore Champion, M Shadows. Shadows retains. What a match. Well, folks, it looks like Hoodfoot and M Shadows may have unfinished business. So we'll see what happens. So stay tuned to our Facebook page and our Patreon, which will be undergoing some minor repairs. But coming up next is our co-main event of the evening, the Monster Abyss versus the Samoan Bulldozer, Umaga. If you thought that match was a monstrous affair, You ain't seen nothing yet. This is about to get absolutely insane. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. On his way to the ring first, the Monster Abyss! And here comes the Monster. The winner of the 2023 Calamity Clash match this past January, securing a spot at Survival Fest next month. Is this man right here? And his opponent, the Samoan Bulldozer, Umaga. And there he is, Umaga. We haven't seen him since the Ustream days. MJF is pulling out all the stops here to get everything into a very, very tight concrete box to give the Monster Abyss challenges that he can barely survive, but Abyss has been truly taking everything that MJF has thrown at him and has succeeded. But can he survive the Samoan Bulldozer? And what is this? Abyss! Clothesline to the back of the head! The bell has rung, the match has begun, and Abyss is taking it to Umaga. My God. It may be over right before it begins. The bell has sounded, Umaga. Already dealing with a lot of damage as the Monster Abyss is trying to make quick work ahead of that tag team match at Rite of Spring. There's a shoulder breaker by the Monster. Wait, Abyss! Uranagi, what a reversal! Abyss just got taken down by Umaga. Umaga's going up top. Huge splash by the Samoan Bulldozer. Cover. One count only. Abyss is back up. Umaga now being pushed into the corner and being worked upon with a series of strong and intense strikes. The Monster Abyss. Oh! This has to be it right here. Big boot. Could we be seeing it? Cover. One, two, no! Not get the Bulldozer down. Black hole slam! Black hole slam! One, two, three. No! You've got to be kidding me. Abyss really trying to unload on Umaga. Face first with that boot, missing the strike. The Samoan Bulldozer now throwing Abyss to the outside. Abyss now in trouble. The leg being jammed up on the floor here of the H2O Wrestling Center. And both men are brawling. And Abyss gets dropped on his face. The referee's up at four. Here we go, five. Jammed right into the barricade. Six. Seven. It looks to me like Abyss. Oh, misses that strike again. And back outside the men go. Will there be any give here? We'll be right back. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. As Abyss is really trying to light up the Samoan bulldozer, but for some reason Umaga really wants to take, in and out. Clotheslined by the monster Abyss. Abyss now being subjected to getting his brain battered, his brain rattled. Oh, what's this? Samoan drop! One. Oh, rope break. And it looks to me like Umaga is pissed. What are we going for here? Oh, he's lifting them. Wait, Abyss. We go for shock treatment. Whoa! Abyss just got reversed. Samoan spike! Samoan spike and a rope break. Gonna try it again. Abyss got reversed. Two count only. Oh, what's this? Oh! Abyss reverses the Samoan spike! But gets slammed on his head afterwards. And we're back to being thrown to the outside and in. And this. Abyss clotheslines into the outside. That's that one. Thrown once again into that barricade. Into the ring post. Three. Oh, slamming him into the barricade. Oh, he's busted open. Abyss is just bludgeoning and pillaging the Samoan bulldozer. And he throws him right into the step. Brings him back into the ring. Abyss now gonna go for something here. Oh, he's going for it. Shock treatment. Shock treatment to the Samoan bulldozer Umaga. One, two, three. That had to be the toughest challenge for the monster yet. Your winner of the match, the monster, Abyss. Well, folks, it's time for our main event of the evening. The SIW Championship. As per request of the Monster Abyss, MJF is contractually told to defend his championship. But he has to defend it against the very guy he faced at the first SIW house show, Austin Theory. The SIW championship is ready to be defended in this match. Our main event is next. So let's not waste any time. Oops. That was not supposed to happen. The following contest is our main event of the evening, and it is for the SIW World Championship. Introducing first, Austin Theory. Austin Theory, the challenger for this match, the appointed challenger. Both MJF and Abyss faced equally as intense individuals. So this can be absolutely intense. his opponent, the reigning and defending SIW champion, MJF. The championship is on the line here, and this is going to be absolutely insane. This series between him and Abyss have been full of different challenges and different opponents and different things in general. It's crazy to think that two contrasting individuals will be hanging horns and throwing haymakers in the main event of Survival Fest if MJF is successful in this match. At the SIW World Heavyweight Championship on the line as Austin Theory, the appointed challenger, takes on MJF. The bell sounds as both men are going to start playing the duping and dodging. Theory going to really try and outmaneuver. What's Max thinking? Oh, is he trying to go to mid? No, it does not work. The mind games are not going to work early on here against Austin Theory. And Max delivers what is truly a remarkable set of clotheslines there. And now he's getting thrown to the floor of the H2O Wrestling Center. Don't forget, folks, this Friday is SIW Rite of Spring. Nice clothesline for the Troubles. And both men are showing very equal prowess here. MJF with a nice European uppercut to Austin Theory. Theory now being completely humiliated here early on in this match. MJF is in solid control. But as usual, every time I say that, a shift in momentum happens. As Theory goes for like a Falcon Arrow. What's this? Theory. Oh! Theory did not see that coming. He was quick to respond. Same with all of that. MJF, I'm gonna try and steal from Theory. Those reversals, one, no. Now I see the mind games are starting to play into everything here as Theory is just getting lit up. A chop here, a chop there, everywhere, a chop, chop, both men. Theory with a blockbuster. Oh wait, MJF is up. Oh! Theory go, damn! World champion rope break. Champs in trouble. Oh, Theory tried to go for something and MJF just rattles him with a clothesline. Now he tries the small package again. No. Really trying to play the mind game card here. And Theory is just getting completely humiliated. MJF gonna try and go. Oh, here we go. Salt of the earth. Rope break. He reaches the rope. A little too close for comfort. Both men trading finishers with each other. MJF is firing back on all cylinders at this moment. Theory with a reversal. Irish whip back into the corner. MJF. Oh, schoolboy, no. Max is just really playing these mind games. Oh, everything is going full reversal. Well, it looks to me like MJF's going to go for it. Crossroads. Crossroads to Austin Theory. One, two, three. Your winner of the match and still SIW World Champion, MJF. Well, folks, Friday night, it's going to be absolute intensity. As MJF and Cruel team up to take on the Monster Abyss and Kevin Nash. We'll see you Friday. Good night, ladies and gentlemen.